Hey everyone, it's Bobby from Lyco Birds with another video in my Bird ID Through the Year series, and this one is going to cover ducks, geese, and swans. And in particular, I want to talk about the structural differences between them, and the ultimate goal is to make sure you're able to distinguish between the various wild and domestic types that you'll encounter. So let's just do a very quick review of some of the key features of these families. First, ducks are small to medium in size. They, of course, have a pretty flattened bill, and oftentimes the plumage on, especially the males, is quite colorful. And mallard is a good representative of the ducks, so most ducks are somewhat similar to this, at least when it comes to structure. And then geese are more medium to large in size, and compared to ducks, they have a somewhat long neck. And we haven't talked about this species yet in the series, but you probably know this is a Canada goose with the brown body and the black neck and head with this white in the cheek that wraps under the chin. And it's Canada goose, not Canadian goose. But this is probably the most common goose you will see, and it's a good one to keep in mind for the general structure. And then we have swans, which are very large. They're among the largest birds. They have very long necks, even compared to geese, and mostly they are strikingly white. And that makes for a good transition to domestic forms of both ducks and geese that can be completely white. And in these photos, the two birds on the left here are both ducks. And then you have these two birds in this top right photo are geese, and the bottom right one is a swan. And mainly you're relying on the structure to tell them apart. So you can see on the two ducks, they have relatively short necks and they have those flattened bills that you see on ducks. And then on these geese, you can see the necks are a little bit longer and the bills are shorter and kind of taller. And the swan, of course, has this extremely long neck. And something to look for on these domestic ducks, and especially on the domestic geese, is a lot of times the rear end looks extremely tall compared to what you would see on a wild bird. Something else to look for is these sort of messy or misplaced tufts that you sometimes will see on these domestic birds, and not all of them do have those, but a lot do, and that's not really something you're going to see on the wild species. And I should also mention that the domestic ducks you see typically are descended from one of two species, and they are both represented here. So this bottom one would be from a mallard, and then the top one would be from a Muscovy duck. And often the simplest way to tell is to just look in the face, and if it has red in the face, it's a Muscovy duck, and if it doesn't, it's a mallard. We'll talk about Muscovy duck for a minute because these really aren't found in the wild anywhere near Pennsylvania, but they are quite common as domestic birds, and they can show variable amounts of white and greenish black. So the greenish black would come from their natural plumage, and then the domestic influence puts a lot of white into many of the birds. And as I was saying, you're looking for a lot of red on the face of these. Mute swan is a bit of an oddball in this topic because they can either be captive birds that are stuck at a single pond and have their wings clipped and can't go anywhere, or they can also be escapees or from a feral population that are basically wild and free-flying. And they've become pretty invasive in many parts of the country. The main thing you're looking for on these compared to the other swans that we might see is they have this orange or sometimes more pinkish, or the really young ones can be more of a gray tone on the bill, but they have then crisp black markings at various points around the border, and they have a dark knob near the forehead. And to confuse matters a little bit more with white waterfowl, we have a wild native goose that is almost completely white, and that is snow goose. And on these, you are looking for mainly the black in the wingtips is a great way to tell these from the other types of white waterfowl. You'll also see that the bill is a little bit different, and they usually have this large black grin patch in the bill. So if you look for those two features, you should be set. So let's circle back to domestic geese, but this time let's talk about the ones that aren't all white and the ones that actually are similarly colored to some wild geese. And this is basically what you would see for plumage on a gray-legged goose over in Europe, but look at the rear end on this thing, how large and tall it is. And as I was saying before, that's usually a dead giveaway that you're looking at a domestic goose. So you want to be especially careful that you're not confusing these with some of the wild so-called gray geese, which could be things like greater white-fronted goose, or wild gray-legged goose, or tundra bean goose, or taiga bean goose, pink-footed goose, stuff like that. And of those species I just listed off, most of them are found more in Europe and would be rare visitors to North America, but greater white-fronted goose actually is native to North America. On these, you can see the overall grayish-brown color with the pinkish bill and the white here at the base of the bill, and that's the so-called white front. And they also have black speckling on the belly as adults. And these are somewhat rare, but definitely regular in the eastern U.S. So I think that should be a good introduction to this topic, and I think it will help the next time you're at your local duck pond and see a lot of confusing white waterfowl. And if you like waterfowl topics, we are headed right into the heart of waterfowl migration, so there are a lot of upcoming videos that are going to be covering, especially ducks, as they start migrating through. So please subscribe to the channel if you want to make sure you don't miss those future videos. And thanks for joining me in this one, and I hope to see you next time.